Ho 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 was a challenge at the 33c3ctf with fairly high points. It's listed in the misc category, which means it's not quite clear what the objective is. The text reads, Santa Claus had a massive multi-day lag and is still stuck at sorting out Christmas trees and presents. Keep in mind that the 33c3ctf happened during the 33c3 conference between Christmas and New Year's. Help him with the trees at, and then we get a server and port to connect to. If he doesn't reward you with a satisfactory present, you might have to bash him a bit. Notice how the bash is written in italic? That is a hint for what this is all about. Bash, the GNU born again shell. And there is a rate limit so you won't accidentally DOS the servers. This was an amazing team effort for us. Like with all challenges during CTF, we didn't do them all alone, but especially this one spanned across the whole team, everybody making a bit of progress. So I didn't do the first parts of the challenge. I joined towards the end, but let me quickly recap what the solutions were for those first parts. So when you connect to the servers, you are greeted with a Merry Christmas and a menu. You can help Santa, continue helping him, visit the North Pole, or quit. So when you decide to help Santa, you get these two trees, which are actually a special version of the Towers of Hanoi. And also you get a unique ID that tracks your progress. You can use that ID with the continue option to continue where you left off. That's a great help. You have to sort these layers to their respective place and the rules of Hanoi applies, that you can't place a bigger layer on top of a smaller layer. You specify the moves with pairs of numbers like 1-3, which moves the red small plate from tree 1 to the empty tree 3. And then you basically just have to solve this. You can quickly find code and examples online about this Hanoi version. And that's what my friends did. They basically wrote some code to solve the Towers of Hanoi and produce a file with those moves that are necessary. After you solved it, you get another menu where you can simply answer some questions, but they kinda got stuck there. You can note down the unique ID you used to solve it, or to be more precise, only up to the last move, and then you can very quickly get to this menu again to figure out the next stage. As far as I know, at this point another person started working on it as well. I think by just trial and error and after quite some more time spent on this, he noticed a bash eval error in only one particular branch of the question answer tree. Bam, there we have it. There's a bash shell injection. Our input is passed to an eval in a bash script. So from here on, it should be simple, right? Well, this is where the real challenge started. My friend wrote a little script to comfortably test the bash injection, so you could simply run that script and quickly test the payload. With that, he slowly figured out, by more trial and error and systematic testing, you are not allowed to use any letters or numbers, except you must use one N or I for the option selection. And all other special characters are allowed. That's very, very restrictive. How the heck can we get basically now a full command injection working if we can't use letters to launch any program? I think I joined here my friend at like 11 PM or something, and we sat down playing around with this bash injection. Obviously, there are a couple of different creative ways to solve this, but they are all kinda based on the same concept. And so before I show you how we did it, let's establish some bash shell basics. I've prepared here a folder with a couple of test files. Now, have you ever wondered what happens when you do something like ls star? You might have thought that ls implements that, but in fact your shell expands this. When you press tab, it will expand it for you right there and not just when you execute it. So you can do stuff like match or expand to all file names that start with an A. Now, think what would happen if you just enter star. Unknown command AAA? Well, that's logical. Star is expanded to all files in this folder, and the first file was AAA. So it thought that is the program to execute, like cat or ls, and the other file names are the parameters. And this shell expansion is very powerful and convenient for us. For example, we know that cat is in /bin/cat. We can try to match this with special characters. Besides star, which stands for as many characters as you want, question mark only represents one character. So for example, slash ?? will expand to all three character files that are in a folder with three characters. And it just happens so that the first one matched is cat. That's very lucky, because this means we can execute cat, and all other file names that match this are passed as an argument to cat. So it will print all these binaries. And obviously we can also follow the cat primitive with more shell expansions like star. So the stars would expand to our files here, the beginning would expand to cat and a lot of crap, but that doesn't matter. In the end, these files here will be printed. And so you can use that now to slowly explore the whole system by trying to match important files. This is how we got the source code for this challenge. This is also how we found the flag file in /flag. The issue is, we cannot read it. Otherwise, we were done already. Apparently, our current user doesn't have the correct permissions. But with this way, we also found a binary that seems to read the flag for us. We just have to execute it. And that's also easy. We can just use shell expansion to execute it, but it also wants a password. The password is as plain text in the binary, and we can see it through cat, but we have no way to enter these characters, right? How can we supply this password now? Well, let me just show you the solution and walk you through. I know it looks ridiculous, but once you dissect it, it's simple. But it took us like 7 hours to figure this out. This was not an easy process for us. We went to bed at like 9 a.m. in the morning after pulling an all-nighter, but we knew we were close, we just needed more time to figure out the details. First of all, there are three sections. There are two function definitions, ä and ö. These are special German characters, but they are not standard ASCII, so they are not filtered. And the third section is actually executing the getFlag program. I mentioned earlier that program gets a parameter, the password. So all these lines just slowly construct the password. How it's doing this, you will understand in a second. So let's have a look at the first function. The first function, ä, is actually just printf. Printf is a program located in user bin printf, and we got lucky that it gets matched by these question marks and the single n which has to be included for printf. As a parameter to printf, we use $at. Variables in bash start with a dollar, and $at is a special variable in bash which represents all parameters passed to this function. So the function a will just call printf with all the parameters we give to it. Nothing special, just a wrapper so we can use printf more often as function a. Printf is cool because we can use escape sequences to get special characters. In particular, we can use octal escape sequences like /101, which is 65 in decimal or hex for 1, so it gets converted into a capital A. Maybe you already get what we are working towards. Now we have a function A that can evaluate escape sequences, thus print any string we like, and it only requires numbers. So we got around the restrictions of letters. So if we find a way now how we get numbers, we can construct escape sequences and then print a string. So let's have a look at the second function, ö. Ö uses now ä, which is printf, to print another special bash variable, $hash. That is like argc in C programming. It represents the amount of parameters passed to this function. So calling ö with 3 parameters will print a 3. And calling ö with 1 parameter will print a 1. Now we have a primitive to construct any number we want. And this is what happens in this last section. There's one ä at the start, which will print a string and evaluate all escape sequences. And then we have a long list of constructed escape sequences. 4 backslashes are necessary, but whatever, they result in one single backslash at the end. Because, like, you have to escape the escape for the escape backslash, whatever. So backslash, and then we call ö with 1 parameter, ö with 4 parameters, and ö with 7 parameters. So backslash 147, which is 103 in decimal, or hex 67, and that's the ASCII character small g. And then we repeat this for every character we want to create. So once you evaluate all the errors, you have a string left with all the escape sequences. Then you do an a printf to evaluate them, and all that is left over is the password for the get flag binary. No ASCII letters or numbers needed, but we can construct any character sequence we want. So when we inject it, we get this beautiful ASCII Christmas present, and at first I panicked because I couldn't see the flag, and I thought, what the fuck? My heart skipped a beat, feeling devastated at 8 a.m. in the morning, but it was there after all. I submitted it, and at that point only 11 teams had solved it. We were really, really proud, and it was a great example of a challenge where the whole team worked together, and I would have never got it by myself.